Mark Rogers TV and last word on sports on Big Ten football. It's a long season. Sometimes teams have to deviate from what they do best, even if they have a defined brand, a defined go-to player, go-to system, even if they're very well defined and know exactly who they are and everybody knows it. Sometimes they have to deviate from who they are in a particular game, a particular matchup. So was Michigan and Indiana this afternoon. Wolverines win it 48-41 in overtime. Michigan football traditionally, Michigan football under Jim Harbaugh. I formation, something we rarely see in college football these days. Utilization of the tight end, inline blocking as a blocker. That's Michigan football. That's what's been established this season again under Jim Harbaugh. Michigan football, play action passing when you need to, but establish the run first on this day. And in the last few weeks, it's been Michigan football throwing the football downfield. We didn't recognize the Wolverines this afternoon. 46 pass attempts from Jake Rudock. This is a game manager quarterback. When anybody thinks Rudock, they think game manager, and not a bad game manager, a pretty decent game manager, a guy at Iowa who won most of his football games, almost had a 2-1 touchdown to pick ratio. But on this day, Jake Rudock had to win the game, and Rudock won the game. 33-46, 440 yards, 6 touchdown passes. Of course, 2 were kind of tainted to a certain extent. Of course, once you go to overtime, the yardage and the touchdowns are there for the taking at the 25-yard line. Rudock, 6 touchdown passes, 1 pick in this one. Michigan relied on the pass to win it. 48-41. They only ran the Wolverines for 141 yards on 28 carries. So that's a pretty productive rushing attack for many teams, but for Michigan, which relies on the run first and foremost, they were halted on the ground. They did not dominate Indiana on the ground. Devion Smith, their leading rusher, 12 carries for 58 yards. Here's a back who is used to ripping off 100-yard games against Big Ten competition. Sometimes teams change throughout the season. So maybe this is a trend for the Michigan Wolverines. Maybe this was by design from Harbaugh, that if we are to beat the likes of Penn State and especially Ohio State and a Big Ten championship game, if we can get there, we need to throw the ball downfield. Brady Hoke, hate to bring up that name, Michigan fans, but he recruited a tight end and wide receiver, some pretty good targets, and Amara Darboh. And, of course, Jake Butt at tight end, and also Jehu Chesson, guys that can make big plays. Michigan has not been lacking for wide receiver talent and a little bit of depth at wide receiver in recent years under Hoke's recruiting. But they have not had the trigger man at quarterback. And even beyond that, they have not had the offensive line that's been able to protect the quarterback for downfield passing attack. But they were able to do it today. They've been able to do it this season. Much improved offensive line play. And we've seen it noticeably in the running game, but on this particular day, we see it in passing. And we've seen Michigan progressively go to the air more and more in recent weeks. I think it's by design to get ready for a very stingy Penn State defense in 1 week. And then, of course, the arch nemesis Ohio State Buckeyes in Ann Arbor to conclude the season. Darboh, Chesson, 2 exceptional targets. And Jake Butt at tight end, players that we saw win matchups in overtime. Jake Butt, mismatch against the safety or linebacker for the first Wolverine touchdown in overtime. Darboh on the stop and go completely lost the defensive back and hauled in the touchdown that eventually won the game from Jake Rudock. Michigan is a passing team. It looks pretty good. Michigan is a defense, dominant early in the season, had the run of 3 consecutive shutouts, but ragged on this day. So we've seen leaks in the Michigan defense against the likes of Michigan State and Connor Cook in particular, but also in recent weeks, they've given up yardage more in chunks than they have and against inferior foes. And on this day was Jordan Howard. The Michigan defense could not stop him. 35 carries for 238 and 2 touchdowns. And this is a kid that ran against just about everybody early season, got hurt against Ohio State, and the Indiana offense has sorely missed him, and then he came back like he had never missed any playing time, and he has been rough to deal with in recent weeks for Indiana. Still, the Hoosiers fall to 0-6 in Big Ten play, and on occasion, the Hoosiers do not look like a bottom feeder in the Big Ten, if you saw the Ohio State game, and then this afternoon against the Michigan Wolverines. Michigan wins at 48-41. Let me know what you think about the Wolverines in particular. Also, Indiana, which ran the ball against the Michigan defense repeatedly, talking about 18 consecutive times leading to that fourth and goal play in overtime when they finally went to the air, which is typical Indiana football before this Mr. Jordan Howard shows up this year and dominates. And, of course, last year he had a great season as well. Nate Sudd fell to the air, and they couldn't convert on fourth goal, end goal, to win the game. So Michigan 48-41, need to hear from you now on Mark Rogers TV.